Hey, Shalom, Shalom. First thing and foremost, I want to give all praises and glory and honor that's due to Yahweh Pashem, Yahweh Shai, Vashem, Rakakwadash. Double honors to the apostles and elders, a great millstone. Peace and blessings and salutation to the whole elect. It was in the gospel, brought living up the standard of Yahweh Pashem, Yahweh Shai, wherever it may be. Real quick, it says the MOTB implants that let you play with your hand. Okay, as the men of the great millstone, starting with the apostles on down, have been prophesied, been speaking about this particular event, and that the world shifting into a particular digital infrastructure. Now, it all started off with, credit cards, credit card pays, debit cards. Then it led up to wireless payments, such as Cash App, Vmail, PayPal. you got different types of apps, contactless apps that allow you to pay via digital transactions, so to speak. Money wiring, wire money within seconds to a particular recipient. Now you have Apple Pay, Google Play, Samsung Pay. And these are all just matter conveniences to get you mentally prepped to accept this MOTB. Now, you got guys in Israel that's still not speaking on this event, or they're speaking against it, ultimately because, Jake, they're filled in the flesh. They're filled with the appetites of this world. So therefore, they're not going to see it the way that's being brought out, because they need to be justified on living in carnality, or they need to be justified on taking it so they can continue their life here in Babylon. Because let's be real, these people don't really want the kingdom, man. Okay? Zabak, Nate, they don't want the kingdom of heaven because they think they're in the kingdom already. And you could tell that the way that they're, you can just tell the way they run their churches, man. They really believe that we're already in the kingdom of heaven. So in their mindset, what could be better than that on earth? And why we got to deal with this right here? They going to negate this, okay? Because ultimately, they don't want to deal with it. And that's fine, because you know what? We just going to say we told you so. And we have been telling you so. And it ain't nothing to throw in nobody's face, like, ha ha, like the brother said, we ain't trying to throw none of you brothers' faces like that, but you got to really realize the reality of this thing and the gravity of what's getting ready to happen. This whole C19 nonsense, all this stuff was all the prelude to bring into this that we're looking at. And now, what are the chances that this shit is all in the news now? All right, and Jake is still oblivious to it because they're getting ready to do away with this dollar, man. Okay, this dollar is getting ready to be broken down and tossed out so they can bring in this. Because we always said, and I've always said it, I said that this is going to replace the currency. Some type of economic collapse or whatever, however they decide to do it. Regardless, they're going to make everybody accept this. That's the reason why you have a famine that's brewing. Reason why you have inflating prices, because they're conditioning you to bow down to the NWO. All right? So it says, this is because a 37-year-old doesn't need to use a bank card or his mobile phone to pay. Instead, he simply places his left hand near the contactless reader and the payment goes through. Right. The Internet of Things. You're being wired up to this system. Okay. And with this, they're able to have all the information and intel on you that they need. And it's going to come a time that you're not going to be able to work a job. You're going to be able to go buy groceries. You ain't going to be able to have an apartment. You ain't going to be able to buy vehicles and etc. unless you receive this MOTB, okay? And like I said, man, we've been speaking on this for ages. I've been in the truth 11 years myself. I've been speaking on it since then, but the apostles, 20, 30, 40 years plus, man. Other brothers, 10 years, 15 years, 20 years, So my little time in the truth, I've been pushing out lessons on the market, on the MOTB daily, okay? Because this is what we're supposed to push. Prophecy, because this is the last prophecy outside of the deliverance that stands between us and the kingdom of heaven. But it's like you brothers, man. I'm not even gonna call you brothers, man. I'm gonna call you Jakes from other camps. All right, because I don't want the men of the Church of the Great Millstone or the brothers that's teaching doctrine. I don't want to lump those brothers in the same category as you Jakes, because you Jakes don't get it. Them brothers get it. And the thing of it is, oh, it's an embargo. Okay, well, if it's an embargo, how do you buy and sell with it? if it's a philosophy or Christianity or white women. So basically, how could I buy and sell? Y'all haven't broke down the buying and selling yet. Yeah. How do you break that down? Okay, that's what you're running from, you know? And a lot of you gonna get caught out there, man, because when it's actually, when this is made mandatory, then y'all gonna be like, oh shit, what do we do? Do we listen to GMS? And a lot of you time, you come against it because y'all hate us. That is what it is. Y'all don't wanna admit that we had it right. So you deliberately go off on the breakdown, man, you know? But some of you are sitting back like, oh yeah, you know what? That do make sense. That is the truth. We know it. We ain't gonna take it, but we ain't gonna get GMS the credit. Like I said, y'all niggas are willing to lose your salvation because you mad at men. That's stupid. Anyway, it says, the reaction I get from cashiers are priceless, says Mr. Paulman, a security guard from the Netherlands. It says he is able to pay using his hand because back in 2019, he had a contactless payment MOTB injected under the you-know-what. It says the procedure hurts as much as when somebody pinches your skin. It says the MC was first implanted into the human back in 1998, but it's only during the past decade that this technology has been made available commercially, right? See, and they tripping because they like, well, it ain't made mandatory yet. Well, okay, but it's coming to that. Okay, it's coming mandatory. It will be mandatory sooner than later. They're going to do something that's going to make this shit legit, man. Okay, and we're trying to tell you, brothers, or you other guys when you other camps, man, that they're going to do something to make this legit, man, that to the point you ain't going to be able to go nowhere without it. Because they're going to say, well, look, this is your social security card, your state ID, your driver's license, all that, man. You know? And it says, and when it comes to implantable payment, it says British police firm Walletmore says that last year it became the first company to offer them for sale. It says the implant can be used to pay for a drink on the beach in Rio, a coffee in New York, and a haircut in Paris or at your local grocery store, says founder and chief executive. I can't pronounce that, not even gonna try. It says it can be used for whatever contactless payments are accepted, but it says Walletmore's, which weighs less than a gram, is a little bigger than a grain of rice. It's compromised of tiny MOTBs and the antenna encased in the biopolymer, a naturally sourced material similar to plastic. It says Mr. Perota adds that it is entirely safe and has regulatory approval and works immediately after being implanted and will stay firmly in place. It says it also does not require a battery or other power source. But the firm says it has sold more than 500 of the you-know-whats, man. So, like I said, this is going to be the thing of the future, you know? And I'm not going to read the whole article. It's pretty long. But nonetheless, this is mainstream media now, okay? And we've been saying it. We've been saying it. You know? Because it says here, the RFID you-know-whats are being used in pets to identify them when they're lost. And that's a lie because every time you look on a corner somewhere and you look on those wooden power poles, you see, have you seen my dog? If that really worked, people wouldn't have lost dogs running around here. Okay, and they probably did find them, but a lot of times people don't find their pets, even if they tagged. So that's all bullshit, man. Okay, that is Esau's way of wanting to control every goddamn thing. You know, because they do have tracking capabilities. That's the whole purpose. But it's going to be more of a detriment than a help, you know. It's like your brothers, man. My allergies, they working with that fucking Edomite, man. You smell like dog, man. It's fucking with my allergies and shit, man. So it kind of put me back, set me back. Fucking throat is scratchy. I hate that. You know, that's why I need to work by myself. I can't stand working with other people. You gotta be susceptible to their fucking sicknesses, man. I can't deal with that shit. That's why we gotta get the hell up out of this place, man. This place is fucking hell. You know, you gotta smell somebody's ass, somebody's funky ass all the time. I can't do that shit no more, man. I'm cool, you know. But anyway, Slovakia, it says, but it's not impossible to locate them using a plant. It says the missing pet needs to be found physically. Then the entire body gets scanned into the, you know what, implant is found in red. So it's the whole point of putting it in there if you just can't find it. Okay, if you got to capture the damn animal and find it. That's the case, you would never find a damn animal, man. What's the whole point of getting this stuff, putting in them? You know, like brothers got pets and stuff like that, man. Cats, dogs, whatever, and you gotta get them tagged up. Like, that's folly, you know, tagging up animals and humans. Okay, but like I said, this is this devil's plan. Okay, it says, but yet the issue with such things and what causes concern is whether in the future they become ever more advanced and packed full of a person's private data. And I believe they already have those already in lines ready to be rolled out. It's just a matter of time before they push it, because they know that Esau, he deals with gradualism. You know, he ain't just gonna come out and say, well, look, everybody line up and go ahead and get your implant, whatever you wanna do. He ain't gonna do it that way, man. He's gonna cause a scenario on a scale that's gonna be so catastrophic to the point people are gonna be begging for this shit. That's what it is, because he knows people is just not gonna line up and willingly go down there and get this tag. They're not gonna do that shit. People like that damn stupid, man. So he was like, okay, well, we know that won't work. So let's find a way on how we can get people to accept this. So let's go ahead and let's collapse the economy. Let's set up a pocket nuke in downtown LA or some shit and cripple LA's infrastructure, scare people so bad to the point that the food systems are disrupted. Then they will come begging us for a solution. And that's how you're going to get most of you fucking dummies, man. Because y'all going to fall for the okie doke. But the prophets are telling you, look, don't fall for that shit. That's why, you know, the beautiful thing about us and you people. See, the thing, the Lord, we have the eyesight. We can see through Esau's folly. We can navigate through this matrix and know where the danger is. But you people, you don't foresee it, okay? Because you're too caught up in the matrix, you know? Y'all trying to learn how to dodge bullets and fly that way. And we stopping bullets, man. And that's the whole point. That's the difference between us and you people are still scoffing, man. I just can't get with that. Well, don't get with it, because the Most High is going to get with you. Well, I don't know if I want to believe that. Y'all teaching is June. Ain't no. Look, man, you ain't got to believe anything that we bring out. If you don't believe it, that's on you. Okay? We know what we got to do. And damn sure we ain't dealing with this. Okay? He can take this and he can take his juice and he can drink both the motherfuckers, man. Okay? And you people can have as much as you want. I don't want it. Okay? And you can have the leftover juice. You can have the frozen juice. You can have the hot juice. I don't give a shit, man. I just don't want to drink the shit. Okay? Because honestly, we want salvation. And this little crummy-ass kingdom is the fucking problem, okay? This kingdom stands between us and the kingdom of heaven, man. This place has to go, man, okay? Regardless, so I just pray that he come on with it. You know, stop dragging your fucking knuckles and go ahead and do what you're supposed to do, bro. Okay? Because regardless of it, you still going down, man. Okay? You going down, E. So go ahead and accelerate that shit, man. The hell you putting on a parachute for at the edge of the cliff? Jump, nigga. Okay? Jump. It says, and in turn, whether this information is secure and if a person can need to be tracked. But financial technology or fintech expert Theodore Lau is the co-author of the book Beyond Good, but how technology is leading a business-driven revolution. X, Y, and Z, I don't care. Blase, blase. We don't care about your innovative shit. But this is the book of Isaiah 6, and I'm going to start at verses, let's start at verses 7. It says, and he laid it upon my mouth and said, lo, this hath touched thy lips, and thy iniquity is taken away, and thy sin purged. But also I heard the voice of the Lord saying, whom should I send, and whom will go for us? Then said I, here am I, send me. Now this is an angel that went forth to blind you Israelites, man, because you just don't want to see it. So the Most High has a certain amount of you blinded and in a rebellious state of mind, because that's how much the Lord hates you, man. The Lord literally blinds you and he don't want you to understand his secrets, is because he really wants to destroy you. And that's another thing too. Off the time we get frustrated with our loved ones that they don't get it, that they're not trying to see it. Don't even get frustrated. You got to look at it like, damn, the Lord must really hate this individual for them to buck up and to not accept this fact that the truth is what it is. You can prove it through the scriptures, through secular history. You can show prophecies that's come to pass. You can break down the last two kingdoms in the book of Daniel. You can break down the He-Goat. You can break down the Persians and the Medes. Well, the Persians and the Medes. You can break down the Roman Empire to them. They ain't going to believe it. It could be one thing. Oh, well, you know, I don't like the fact that, you know, brothers or men can do this and that. So therefore, fuck the truth. You know, you turn your whole back on it. That's fine, you know, because the Most High has something for individuals like that. And it says here, and I also heard the voice of the Lord saying, I read that. And he said, go and tell this people, hear ye indeed, but understand not, and see ye indeed, but perceive not, and make the heart of this people fat, and make their eyes heavy, and shut their eyes, lest they see with their eyes, and hear with their ears, and understand with their heart, and be converted, and be healed, okay? But Jake don't want to do that, okay? Jake want to teach against it. Well, it's an embargo. It's Christianity. It's sleeping with white women. You know what I'm saying? It's bagging up brown paper bags and whatever dumb folly that you Jake's come up with. You know what I'm saying? And it's none of those things. It's just straightforward. Okay, the whole world is shifting over to this type of infrastructure. How can you people not see that? How can you people not see that in the very near future that cash is going to be done away with? Everything's going to be done through digital transaction or digital means. How can you not see it that way? How can you not know or believe that this is going to be the mandating thing that's going to allow your life to go forward, man? Okay, if you don't deal with it, then you at an abrupt halt. How can you people not see that and understand it and get on board? Like, I get it, but the other half of me, like, it's just like you Jake's either stupid as hell, or you just don't give a damn, you know? Because a lot of you, like I said, when they start announcing this, because this is mainstream media now, but when they start really throwing this in your face, that's when a lot of you people gonna reconsider. Well, maybe Great Millstone had it right. A lot of you gonna be hitting up comment boards, asking the elders and apostles. A lot of you gonna create fake accounts, man. You know, you ain't gonna say that I was with Priest Zabok. You ain't gonna say I was with Bishop Nate. You ain't gonna say I was with General Yohana. You ain't gonna say that, man. You gonna try to creep your little monkey ass in and get built up so you don't have to do it. Well, hey, well, fine, whatever. Repent. You know, but majority of you, you gonna be stuck in the middle. You know, and a majority of you Israelites in these different camps, man, you gonna take it. Okay, you gonna take it because you ain't built up not to take it. You gonna take it because it's to the point they gonna start threatening people with death with this shit. They fucking kicking your door and hold you at gunpoint, and they hold your newborn baby at gunpoint, they holding your wife at gunpoint. A lot of you niggas are gonna fold, man, like a cheap suit, bro. I can see it now, because it's not a light thing having somebody threaten to blow your head off because you don't accept this MOTB shit. And then you got a wife, you got a kid. That's why we tell brothers all the time, hey man, it's better to mentally detach from your family, man, because they may die. Okay, and I mean, that's not a light thing. I think about it all the time. I'm like, damn, you know, I got a daughter. I'm like, I got a chick, you know what I'm saying? What if X, Y, and Z, you know what I'm saying? I think about the shit all the time, you know, but I got to think about, like, my salvation and me being strong. I got to think about Yehovah Shimei HaVashai, because I have to think about what these people have done to offend the Most High. So at the end of the day, their death is not my fault, because they've been warned. Yeah, it will fuck you up, it will break you down, it will hurt like hell, knowing that your loved ones are being put to death right before you. But shit, that's just how the Lord has it, man. So we have to be in the spirit of being built up to not falter. You should be able to look at death in the face and be like, look, it is what it is at this point. And the Most High is going to put an emboldened spirit on his men to deal with that shit. But you other camps out there, you not prepped for that, man. Sakari, you niggas are not prepared, man. You walk around here with titties on your gun, as you call it, and you think you're going to do something? You think you're going to gun it out with this devil? You think you're going to really gun it out with this devil, right? Esau could send him one Terminator and eliminate every last one of your fucking camps, man. One Terminator is all he need. You niggas ain't shooting it out with Arnold, man. I'm going to just leave it at that, so y'all can keep the Colonel shit over there. Because y'all dudes, man, y'all just way in over your heads, and you guys are very delusional. Okay, you're highly delusional if you think that you're going to get a stronghold on this devil with his own blessing. You crazy, man. This man will make your ass disappear. This dude is in the Most High gave him the power. That's why I tell you, fight against him. You fighting really against the Most High, because he's the one, the Most High set his ass up for this very purpose. And the Most High going to do away with him. All right, it says, but he said, then I, Lord, how long? And he answered, until the cities be wasted without inhabitants, and the houses without men, and the land be utterly desolate, man. Okay, so you Jakes ain't gonna get it until this place is completely destroyed. When you see the missiles come, that's when you Jakes are gonna really get with the program. Oh man, oh, that's when the Lord gonna take them blinders off you, when you seeing the missiles come down here. Then you're gonna be like, oh man, I should have listened. Oh, it's gonna be too late. ain't gonna be, you're gonna repent 2 seconds before the missiles come, but you already got the Karag menu. You out of here, man. Ain't no, you ain't gonna get it out in 2 seconds. And even then, if you try to be slick like that, the Most High gonna still destroy you because you tempting the Lord. Why would you do something like that? Okay. So this is Revelation 13:11. It says, in that knowing the time that is now, it's a time to wake up out of sleep. For now is our salvation nearer than what we believe. And that's why the purpose of this lesson. Okay, look at this. This is actual BBC News. And, you know, and I can go. I just typed it in and you can find it on different pages. Brothers got all types of articles on it. Brothers have done lessons on it. You know, brothers have spoken on it. Now this is like literally mainstream. Okay, Fox5NY.com. FoxBusiness.com. This is 3 days ago. Look at this. See? And that devil Biden told Justice Roberts, he said, you're going to rule on that before your tenure is over. And what is the chance that we got this pedophile loving nigga woman, Ketanji Brown, over the Supreme Court? You think she's not going to allow this to be mandated? You crazy as hell. This is a black woman doing a bidding of her fucking lover, Esau. She's going to allow it. Or however it works. Okay? However it works. She's not going to shut it down. I'll tell you that. Because she's too in league with Satan, man. Okay? That's why we tell you, brothers, hey, beware of Eve. She ain't with you. You know? This is the book of Ezekiel. My throat fucking scratchy, man. I hate when I get like this, bro. I'll be working with some nasty ass cracker. Damn. Niggas can't get a break here. But anyway, this is the book of Ezekiel 3. And I'm going to start at verses 17. It says, and son of man, I've made thee a watchman unto the house of Israel. Therefore, hear the word of my mouth and give them warning from me. Okay? This is, we're watchmen. We're watching, we're blowing the trumpet. This is why we're telling you of the prophecies, man. It says, when I say unto the wicked, thou shalt surely die, and thou givest him not warning, nor speakest to warn the wicked from his wicked way to save his life. The same wicked man should die in his iniquity, but his blood would I require at thy hand. Right. So you ain't warning your congregations, they're going to be destroyed, and you're going to be destroyed. Regardless. It's a collective effort. You're not telling your congregation, oh, well, this is what it is. Then eventually, the Most High is going to take out all of y'all. You see? But it says here, yet if thou warn the wicked and he turn not from his wickedness, nor from his wicked way, he should die in his iniquity. But thou have delivered thy soul. Okay? So, there you go. We trying to deliver our souls, whether you listen or not. That's the whole point. So, you Jakes, man, you better get in, you better get with it fast. And it says again, when a righteous man doth turn from righteousness and commit iniquity, and I lay a stumbling block before him, he shall die, because thou have not given him warning, he should die in his sin, and his righteousness which he have done should not be remembered, but his blood I will require at thy hand. But nevertheless, if thou warn the righteous man that the righteous sin not, and he doth not sin, he should surely live, because he is warned. Also thou hast delivered thy soul. Okay, so that's the whole point I wanted to make. But I'm going to end it there, man. You know, we can go all day with this. Giving all praises and glory and honor that's due to Yahweh by Shimei HaWashai. And with that, Shalom and a Baba Ball.